While we've all heard of Spotify promo, YouTube promo, Instagram ad promo, what about Apple Music promo? And look, I know it seems complicated, but once you watch the full video, then you're gonna understand how to promote your music on Apple Music, build your fan base, and get real human listeners on your Apple Music track. DistroKid is gonna show, boom, 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 new royalties from your Apple Music streams. And thing is, there's a roundabout method to growing on Apple Music, because Spotify is pretty simple. You've probably seen me or somebody else tell you, okay, to get any kind of Spotify growth, you just kind of get your playlists, get your promo packages. It's that simple. But Apple's a little bit more complicated. And the main reason is because, you know, the thing about Apple Music is it's so closed off. Just as a company, Apple isn't a fan of sharing any software space with any other companies, which is why they have their own headphones, they have their own speakers, own everything, even their own music app. So if you want to get somebody on Apple Music to listen to your stuff, to target them, you'll have to use different kind of methods than if it was Spotify. Spotify is designed for discoverability, hence why they have Discover Weekly as well as Release Radar. But it's not going to be the same on Apple Music. So Apple Music is going to consist mainly of different types of promotional methods. Number one, advertising. You're going to have to run ads and use other advertising platforms to get heard on Apple Music, of course. So as long as your sound is good, everything is ready, you have a nice cover art, it's perfect, it's on DistroKid, it's released, then you can get started with the advertising. So what you can do is you can host ads, or you can go to an agency that's gonna be running the ads for you. And if you wanna know what the big difference is between you running your own ads towards your Apple Music tracks versus having an agency work with you, is the fact that an agency generally has advertising experience. Also, an advertising agency such as Boost Collective is gonna be helping you grow your music and grow your fan base on your Apple Music tracks, because they have what's called strategies. Listen, they're gonna be advertising and they're gonna be trying to get the best bid, and they're gonna optimize it perfectly to get real listeners. Compared to if you're doing it by yourself, if you don't know anything about advertising, then it's gonna be tough, a lot of money down the drain. Ads are not cheap, not at all. So you gotta understand that part, but you can go and do it by yourself. And while you're advertising by yourself, you gotta understand one thing. It's best if you just keep the ad very simple. Maybe have like some sort of motion graphic, some sort of visual, and then once you have it of different dimensions. For example, you're gonna be advertising your Apple Music track, you're gonna be running ads, either Google and Instagram ads. Have one that's gonna be square, have one that's gonna be the full portrait rectangle, and one that's widescreen. So you have to make different type of designs for different types of ads, because honestly, it's gonna fit best on different platforms. Say you're gonna be running your ads towards your Apple Music track, then you're gonna have to use all the different dimensions. Just keep that in mind. Another thing about advertising on Apple Music is the fact that playlists are really hard to get on. And let's say you do get a playlist on Apple Music, how much can that really help you? Think about it. On Apple Music, what we have on Spotify is a number of how many people are following. We get to see who the people are. We can vet if it's organic and all that good stuff. However, it's not the same on Apple Music. But the good thing is that if you do get Apple Music promo, you can be sure that it's not gonna be bots. And the main reason is because you need to have an actual account signed with Apple to even use Apple Music in the first place. That means that you can't just have some sort of computer servers running and then trying to get you streams on Apple Music unless all the prerequisite steps to set up the account is made. Whereas if you're to promote your music on Spotify, for example, it's very easy to get bots. And it's probably a pretty fair chance if you use like, you know, 3, 4, 5 different marketing agencies that at least one of them had bots, one or more. Only because the fact that it's so easy to just open up a new window, stream your song without making any account or anything, because, you know, they have Spotify free, or get some sort of bot that can create a new account with the username of ABZXT, whatever kind of computer generated name, and then start streaming that way, which is the most famous way that streaming bots are created. Apple Music can't do any of that. So you have to either do it by yourself or get the help of professionals such as myself to help you run the ads for your Apple Music campaign. Can't talk today. One thing you do understand also is the fact that on Apple Music, they pay slightly more than they do on Spotify. And the main reason is because Spotify has so many different artists, they're all kind of competing for the same pie. And sure, while other artists are gonna be putting their music out on Apple Music as well, they're not promoting it on Apple Music. So what you see is people, they, you know, go for playlist placements, which is a really valid and really, you know, organic way to grow on Spotify. But on Apple Music, they put zero efforts. So what happens is that there's more on the table for you to be grabbing in terms of Apple Music promotion. So if you can be really good at Apple Music promotion, then it's kind of an empty playing field in a way. One other thing to keep in mind is, since Spotify is built exactly for discoverability, you're getting that benefit, but so are other artists. Meaning that you have to do extra competition within the app itself. But if you look at Apple Music, the way it's laid out and everything, unless you're one of the Drakes or Kanye West getting the Apple Music exclusives, such as Donda, for example, the whole, you know, listening viewing party, the live thing, that's not available to small scale artists such as you. Meaning that on the independent artist level, the competition is a lot lower because you're not going against all these guys within the platform. So it's built kind of like a file management app, Apple Music itself. Once people have their songs, they'll listen to their songs more frequently, and they're not really gonna add new songs unless it's from a top name. If you can slip your song through the cracks, through advertising, find a way for other people to listen to your track on Apple Music, trust me, they will listen to your music on repeat. People are pretty loyal, and the fans that are on Apple Music really, really like their playlists, and they wanna keep it a certain theme. You wanna be in those playlists because you are not getting removed from those playlists anytime soon. Whereas on Spotify, discoverability every 7-8 days, maybe 2 weeks, a month, regardless of the time frame, your song will generally be removed from a playlist, which is okay, you find another playlist, but on Apple Music, you don't have to worry about that. And I think that's an important distinction about promoting on Apple Music. Last thing you gotta know before you end, wrap this video up, is try not to do it yourself. You know, go on YouTube, watch videos about how to learn advertising, whether it's Facebook or Google or YouTube, whatever it is, because look, it's gonna be a lot of money, real talk. And a lot of artists don't have that kind of budget to learn how to maybe run ads to promote your music when you just wanna get heard. So we can help you, but if not, you undo yourself, all good. I wish you all the best, have a damn good one, and tell Tim Cook, I said hey.